Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. Few months ago I covered two videos on the QSBI peripheral in STM32, which covered how to initialize the QSBI, write data into it, and read data from it. We also saw how to enable the memory mapped mode, and how to execute an application from the QSBI memory. Both of those videos were focused on the N25Q series, and MT25 series NOR flash memories, which already has an external loader in the SD's record. Today we will cover the QSBI again, but for the W25Q series NOR flash memories. These chips are widely available, and they are comparatively cheaper. We will also see how to create an external loader, so we can debug and load the code into the QSBI memory. We will cover this in two parts. In the first part we will see the connection, and also cover the read, write, erase, and memory mapped mode for the W25Q series flash memories. In the next part we will see how to create an external loader for a specific controller and memory device, and how to debug the external memory using the external loader. You can find more details about the STM32 QSBI in the application note, AN4760. Here you can see the list of microcontrollers that support the QSBI. More detailed info about these controllers can be seen below. Here you can see the list of microcontrollers along with the maximum speed and other details. You need to check the notes provided with the microcontrollers before you start with the QSBI. For example, the STM32F446 series has the note 4. It says that the LQFP only supports bank 1 with single and dual lines. So if you have the Nucleo F446 board, it does not support the QSBI. Basically, the low-pin development boards by ST do not support the QSBI, so make sure to check the availability here. I have the L496 development board, and it supports the maximum speed of 60 MHz in the single data rate mode. Also, the maximum space in the memory mapped mode can be 256 MB. You can check more details about the QSBI in this PDF. ST has a repository on the GitHub, which contains the QSBI drivers for a few flash memories. In my previous video about the QSBI, I showed how we need to use this driver structure in our project. They don't have the drivers for the WinBond chips, but we can create one with few modifications. We will use this repository to create an external loader for our board, but in the next tutorial. Alright, let's start the Cube IDE, and create a new project. I am using the Nucleo L496 development board. Give some name to the project, and click Finish. Let's set up the clock first. I am using the internal oscillator to generate the maximum 80 MHz clock for the CPU. Now go to the connectivity, and enable the QuadSBI bank 1 with quad lines. We will configure the parameters later, let's set up the pins first. Here is the schematics of the board I am using, and you can see the pins allocated for the QuadSBI. I will set up these pins in the Cube MX. Here is the connection between the W25Q32 and the MCU. The flash memory is powered with 3.3 volts, and the rest of the pins are connected to their respective counterparts on the board. Alright, now we will configure the parameters. As per my clock setup, APB1 and 2 both are running at 80 MHz, so the QuadSBI should also be at the same clock. You can check out the clock diagram in the datasheet to see which bus is connected to the QuadSBI. Anyway, right now the QuadSBI clock is at 80 MHz, but the board supports the maximum clock of 60 MHz, as we saw in the beginning. So I am using a prescaler of 1, which actually is the value 2, and it will reduce the APB clock to 40 MHz. Set the FIFO threshold to 4, and the sample shifting half cycle. The flash size can be calculated using the formula shown here. I have 4 MB memory, so the flash size is 21. Now go to the project manager, code generator, and check generate peripheral as a pair of C and H files. Click save to generate the project. Here you can see the Quadspi file has been generated separately with our configuration. I have the Quadspi source and header file with the required modification for the W25Q series memories. Let's copy the user code 0 and the user code 1 in the respective position. Now copy the content of the header file in the Quadspi header file. Let's build the code once to check for any errors. If you are using any other memory size, you need to modify the memory size here. The block size, the sector size, and the page size remains the same throughout the W25Q series, so you don't need to worry about them. The chip commands are also the same, but I would advise to cross-check them with the datasheet once. Our QSBI driver is ready, so let's test it. Define a buffer to store the data to be written into the memory, and another buffer where we will save the data read from the memory. In the main function, initialize the QSBI. We will erase the entire chip, and then write the data into the memory. This location 0 is with respect to the memory, it is basically the beginning of the memory. Now we will read 100 bytes of data from the same memory location. Alright, let's build the code. We don't have any errors, so let's debug it now. I am setting a breakpoint at the read function, and you can see the write buffer contains the data to be written. Let's run the debugger now. The chip erase takes around 10 to 20 seconds to complete. Alright, we have hit the breakpoint, so the write is complete. The read buffer is empty right now. Let's step over this statement. The read buffer now has the data which we stored in the memory. We read 100 bytes, so the rest of the data in the buffer is FF hex. This is because the entire chip was erased and hence it contains the FF hex. So we were able to write and read the data from the memory. If we try to access the memory in the memory window, we can't access it. To access the memory here, the MCU must see the flash memory as a part of it, and this is where the memory mapped mode comes in. Let's enable the memory mapped mode for the flash memory. Now we will comment out the read function, and copy the data from the memory location to the read buffer using memcopy. The memory location 90 million hex is the address for the QSBI, and it remains the same for most of the STM32 controllers. Anyway, you can confirm it in the reference manual of your controller. Go to the system and memory overview. Here you can see the memory distribution for this MCU. The Quadspi flash is located at the address 90 million hex. Note that the locations for the external memories are already defined the MCU, even though the memories are not connected. So if you connect them in future, you need to use these memory locations for the respective memories. I have stored the data at the beginning of the memory, so I am accessing it at the address 90 million hex. Let's include the string header file for the memcopy function. Alright, let's build and debug the code now. I am setting a breakpoint at the while loop, so it will hit once all the processes has been completed. The arrays will again take around 10 seconds. Alright, we have hit the breakpoint, which means everything above was processed. We have the data in the read buffer, so the memcopy function succeeded. The fact that we can use the memcopy function simply means that the MCU now sees the external flash memory as the internal memory. We can also browse the memory in the memory window, and this is only possible if the memory is being treated as the internal memory. So the memory mapped mode worked, and we were able to map the external memory as the internal memory. This is it for this video. I hope you understood how to work with W25Q NOR flash memories using the QSBI peripheral. In the next tutorial we will see how to make an external loader for our MCU with the QSBI flash, and how to debug the flash using the loader. We will later use the QSBI flash to store the data for the LVGL and touch GFX applications. This is it for today. You can download the code from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.